Now that Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is out in theaters, a lot of fans are very intrigued and curious about the future of the Star Wars franchise and exactly how Disney and Lucasfilm will be handling the future of Star Wars as a whole. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, one thing that we do know is that Disney and Lucasfilm are in the stage of creating a brand new Star Wars universe. In case you guys are currently not informed about this, they plan to actually treat the live-action TV series on Disney Plus and the upcoming new Star Wars trilogy, the set of three Star Wars films to come in the 2020s, to all interconnect with each other in a similar pattern like how the MCU is treated. If you look at the MCU, you have a lot of after-credit scenes that kind of preview what's to come next for the new, you know, Marvel movie and stuff around those lines. They're giving us that treatment with the Star Wars universe. And this is all said to have been initiated by Kathleen Kennedy and Disney CEO Bob Iger to really bring Star Wars fans to a different era of Star Wars and to actually treat the franchise in a different way and to evolve it. Now, on top of all of this, the thing about Episode 9 is that it was a foundation to create new Star Wars lore. Basically, this was a way to actually propel the Star Wars universe into something new for books, novels, video games, you name it. However, Disney and Lucasfilm are now developing TV series and movies, etc., that will get the MCU treatment. Now, about the first film of the new Star Wars trilogy dubbed as Star Wars X, what's really exciting about this is that it's explained that both Disney and Lucasfilm are currently developing a series of TV shows and movies to expand the future of the Star Wars franchise into something new and different for fans around the world. Now, this massive shift is said to have been done by Lucasfilm's Kathleen Kennedy and Disney CEO Bob Iger to bring in a brand new mythology of Star Wars as a whole, and that they are now primarily focused on the first film of the set of three new Star Wars movies to come that is dubbed as Star Wars X. It's explained that they are currently in talks with multiple A-list actors to bring on board and to bring them into the Star Wars franchise. Lucasfilm are currently in negotiations with bringing in actors Gerard Butler and Anthony Hopkins for the first film of the new trilogy, and that they are planning the film over in many states over in the US, such as Utah and Colorado for starters, for the first film of the new TV for the first film of the new Star Wars trilogy. Now, they are also looking into Greece, Germany, Italy, and other areas like Croatia and Europe to film sometime during production. Now, it's explained that the first film of the new trilogy and its director has been selected, and that Kathleen Kennedy has made the choice to not only include Jon Favreau to have some form of a role during production, but also Dave Filoni as well in this upcoming project for fans. It's said that Star Wars X will also have some loose connections to the Skywalker saga, and that Disney and Lucasfilm are closing in on their decision of what era of the franchise to explore, and that there will be, and that they actually will be bringing in many pieces of Star Wars legend material to tell a unique and original story for hardcore fans and even new fans around the world. Now, the first film of the new trilogy is also set to be the longest running Star Wars film with the highest budget, as this movie will require far more extras than ever before and will be modeled after Lord of the Rings. Now, it's said that Lucasfilm are looking into Gerard Butler portraying a protagonist for the upcoming Star Wars film, where Disney and Lucasfilm are said to begin a script in February of 2020 and are planning on developing all three Star Wars films at once as one seamless story that will have consistency, and that CEO of Disney Bob Iger has realized what needs to be done to tell a proper story for Star Wars to finish. Now, it's explained that Star Wars X will also be more violent of a Star Wars film and will cater itself to hardcore our fans of the old expanded universe from the 90s and the early 2000s. The film is said to also have a major reveal of some kind over at Star Wars Celebration in August of 2020 in California that will be the highlight of their convention during that time. Star Wars X will also be advised by creator George Lucas, and that some of his ideas will be implemented into the newest film that will kickstart a brand new mythology of the Star Wars universe. Star Wars X will primarily consist of the A-list actors and actresses that will be selected throughout the 2020 year by Lucasfilm and Disney to create a brand new era of the franchise that will be very large in scale, and we will actually evolve the franchise again. So let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, the thing about Star Wars X here is that we went over a couple of days ago, is that they are in negotiations on whether or not they want to use the Roman numeral format basically using episodes 10, 11, and 12 moving on forward. Now, obviously, if you base these movies in the future, that makes a lot of sense. If you base them in the past, it makes absolutely no sense to call it episode 10. So, with Kathleen Kennedy now planning the roadmap of the Star Wars universe, like I say, she is going to be the one responsible for planning it, but she will not be involved with the creative sense of Star Wars X. She's going to have no creative involvement with that actual project. So, that's a thumbs up from me. That really is, because honestly, I think that we need to shift away from Kennedy and that we do need somebody else to take over as head of Lucasfilm. Honestly, everything seems to be pointing toward Jon Favreau based on the comments by CEO Bob Iger and how he expressed that he basically reminds him of how George Lucas was a visionary. And Jon Favreau, let me tell you, he really is a visionary. It's one of the main reasons as to why The Mandalorian works so well and feels just like Star Wars A New Hope. It has that old and gritty feel. It has that original touch to it. And that's what I like so much about Jon Favreau in The Mandalorian, is that he really went all out with this series, and he's going to go all out even more with Season 2 that's due for release in fall of 2020 next year. So, everything related to Star Wars X, the thing that impresses me the most is how they are looking at Anthony Hopkins and Gerard Butler to actually be a part of this new movie. Now, like I say what you will about Gerard Butler. A lot of people have, you know, some problems with some of the movies that he's put out. I honestly think he's an amazing actor. But Anthony Hopkins is on a different level. I mean, he is on a different level on a grand scale here. He is a legendary actor. And if he accepts the role for a Star Wars movie, I think that a lot of fans are really going to tune in, because there's a lot of Anthony Hopkins fans out there. Now, obviously, when you think about Anthony Hopkins, you don't really think too much about, you know, movies like Star Wars. Sure, he has been in some sci-fi oriented projects like Westworld, which, by the way, J.J. Abrams was loosely involved with that. But the thing about Anthony Hopkins is that this, all right? We do know that he's a legendary actor, number one. Is he a best fit for Star Wars? I think a lot of people are going to have different opinions on that. As far as other elements of Star Wars X goes, of how they're trying to make these movies, or, you know, the first film of the new set of three Star Wars films more violent than others, and how it's going to have a higher budget, the fact that they're making these movies have a higher budget tells us that they are going to be on a bigger scale. It's going to have a different tone to it. And again, they're modeling these movies, the overall feel of them, after Lord of the Rings, which I believe is a telltale sign that this is going to bring us into the Old Republic era. I mean, if you think about it this way, right? If you obviously want to continue Jedi and Sith, which is what they plan to do, where else can you really go? You know, it has to be the Old Republic, or it has to be something based well into the future where, let's say, for example, Rey or her students have established a brand new Jedi Order, and the Jedi just keep multiplying one by one, and now you have hundreds of Jedi going up against, let's say, for example, maybe a new type of enemy that could actually take over the role as a Sith, for all we know, right? So, if they want to go forward, they could do that. If they want to go backward, they can also do that. However, I would prefer to go backward. My only problem with that is, if they actually do stick with the Roman numeral format, it would make no sense at all calling it Episode 10, or Star Wars X for that matter. Again, Star Wars X right now is the code name for the new movie, and it's going to be a big deal because this movie is actually going to have a lot of work going into it. It's one of the main reasons as to why they got a little gap in between, you know, The Rise of Skywalker and this movie. And it's going to be quite a fun ride to finally, when we get to see Disney's vision of where they are going to bring Star Wars. Now, obviously, I was not happy at all with The Last Jedi. I had a lot of problems with it. I was not all about it at all. In fact, I hated the movie. The Rise of Skywalker, I had a lot of problems with too, but I also thought it was a decent Star Wars film. I thought it was a fun, decent, entertaining movie with flaws. Had some scenes I hated, had some scenes I loved. That's basically how I can best describe that movie. Now, when I look at Episode 9, it does indeed, you know, give Disney the opportunity to bring Star Wars in a different direction. Obviously, the box office is doing well. You know, they're not losing money on this thing, so they can do what they want with the future of Star Wars and as they please. So, with that being said, I'm still intrigued with how these new Star Wars movies are going to look and how they are going to be done by Lucasfilm, you know, you name it, especially the fact that Kathleen Kennedy will no longer be involved with them on a creative scale. So anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all this in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time. Night to move.